had his big budget team realize or conclude that it was a hoax. It was a guy that came from Colorado claiming it, if you recall, that disc, and it was a speaker. This has amazingly different, different a quality to it. First of all,
Well, look at
the
the,
detail, the
yeah,
detail, you
you know
just
exactly
cannot
right.
be blown away.
Look at the retractable legs, if that's what you'd call it, landing gear retracting up and down. You got reflection left and right, refraction. You got something that the pixelation, you just don't see a hoax as good as
And then it
this.
looks
If it's
like
a
it's
hoax, I don't
almost.
think so. Salvador and Jose just seem like legit kind of guys, if you ask me.
Yeah, and that's another thing that I like about it. The fact that two separate people caught it, two different videos of the same object, and then it's zoomed in from a distance, it gets pixelated when it gets closer, but then it looks like it's got like glass on top, and as you said, it retracts. Now, the three is important, I'll tell you why. So many people talk about three legs. For instance, astronaut Gordon Cooper witnessed a landing and recorded it on film at Edwards Air Force Base, I believe in the 50s. He said a saucer, flying saucer, came down and landed, put out three legs and landed and just stayed there for a bit and then took off. He developed the film, then looked at it, and then it was going up the chain of command, put in a briefcase, chained to an officer's wrist, and sent off. Then you have the Socorro, New Mexico. Lonnie Zamora, where did he see an egg-shaped craft with three legs? And then, of course, Rendlesham. To this day, there exists, because in case people say they were lunatics and nothing landed, they actually took impressions from the ground.